Welcome guys, once again. In this session, we'll see how to execute multiple classes using TestNg. So as of now, if you are using Java, you cannot run multiple classes at a time, okay? You can run in one class, you can have multiple switch and case or if else condition, and you can, you know, trigger, you can call the method present inside another class, but at a time, you cannot run multiple classes test method, right? Now, let's see with TestNg how easy it is, okay? So we'll see with very small example. So I have one test class, okay, test3. In that I have three test methods, okay? I have three test method, and TestNg, this is all TestNg method because I have marked all the test methods with @test annotation. Means TestNg will understand this is a test case, right? Simple. So I have three test cases, okay, in this test class. If I'll execute, so obviously three test case will be executed. But if I want to execute at the same time this test4 methods also, how it will be possible? So yes, with TestNg it is possible. So we can have the TestNg.xml, and by using that you can execute. So I have simple mark as, you know, test class, test3.test1, test3.test2, test3 and test4. Okay, means class third and test whatever. So in test3, three test methods are there, okay? Then again test4, in two test methods are there. So I have mentioned also test4, test1, test2, okay? So how to execute this both classes methods? So total, if I'll combine both together, it will be 5 method, okay? 3 test method and 3 test method, means total 2 and this 3, 5 test cases, right? So how to execute multiple test classes? So simple, test3. So I'll go to test3, this .java file, do right click, okay? Once you'll do right click, go down and see the TestNg options, okay? Then go to TestNg, then you will be having option called convert to TestNg. I'll do double click. By default it will give you location, you know, TestNg.xml. So this name you can change as per your convenience, like sanity, regression or whatever, okay? So as of now I am not changing anything, let it be TestNg.xml, okay? Suit name also you can change, and test name also you can change. So as of now I'm not changing anything and I'm just giving default. If you'll see, this is class selection. So what level you want to run, package level or class level? So I want to run class level, so let it be parallel mode. As of now I'm running none, okay? I don't want to run parallel. Thread count, I'm not giving anything. So as of now this is all default, I'm not configuring anything, okay? I'll just do finish. As soon as I'll do finish, I'll get one file called testng.xml file. I'll do double click. I'll just open testng.xml file, and this is, see how it will look like. So it will be having option like this structure. So suit, it will be there like suit name, then parallel is equal to none, okay? So as of now testng, okay, it will validate this xml file also, with this testng.xml, and this it will find that, okay, parallel is none, so it will throw some exception, okay? We'll see this output as well. Then here I can give the test name, n number of test I can give, and inside test I can give classes, and inside classes I can give n number of classes. So as of now in this class I have only one class, you know, testng test1.test3. so this is package name followed by class name. So this will execute only if I'll give this parallel. As of now I'm giving false, so I don't want to run in parallel, so I'm giving false. So test3. So now I'll just go and execute from testng.xml. right click, run as testng should. Perfect.